Hey everyone, welcome to my devlog series, where every month I post a video with all the fixes and new stuff that I add to my adventure JRPG game Kotomasho. This video will be posted 1 week earlier on Patreon, as well as other exclusive content. So if you haven't already, go over to patreon.com/wallgallen and support me over there for more early previews, behind the scenes, and cool rewards like digital downloads, or even being part of the game. But anyways, let's stop stalling and start with the devlog. So, this month I worked on two of the songs that will be appearing on chapter 2 of the game. Previously, I had one of the three songs, which was the Song of Unlocking, which I think I previewed on the first devlog, and right now I worked on the two new songs and the two new mechanics that I added. So, the first one is the Song of Treasure, which is called Tommy's Treasure Charm, and this song is basically to find hidden treasure on the ground in certain areas of the game. Whenever you find this treasure spot on the ground in basically any part of an overworld, not inside a dungeon or inside a building, you play the Song of Treasure and a treasure of any kind will appear. It could be upgrades or it could be something like dream drops. This song is also gonna be Tommy's main theme. Tommy is basically the store clerk for every single 7-Eleven store in the game, and he's a very important character, not specifically for this game, but overall for the whole franchise that I have planned. And yeah, I know, planning a whole franchise before launching a single game is kinda ridiculous, but I really think I will be doing it, so yeah, Tommy is kind of an important character, so he's having a main theme. And this song, I really like how it turned out, so I hope you like it. So the next song is called the Song of Restoration. This mechanic basically turns back time on certain objects. It does not turn back time on people, it just turns back time on objects. So basically this mechanic is to repair certain objects. The first mechanic that I implemented was bridges. So there will be broken bridges all over the place, and you can restore them with this song to be able to cross to hidden places or progress in the story. Those are the two new songs for the game. Now we have 3 out of 10, and these are the 3 that will be appearing on chapter 2. Oh, I also added a ton of treasure spots in the prologue and chapter 1 areas. So if you play the prologue and chapter 1 on Steam right now, you will be able to see mysterious treasure spots all over the place, which you can't use yet, but they will be there for sure, ready when you can use them in chapter 2. I also modified a very small area in the Silky Woodlands to implement the restore mechanic as well, so you will notice a certain area that was different from before with a bridge to repair. Now, continuing with the chapter 2 major new stuff, I basically finished writing the whole chapter 2, so I'm very excited. I don't think I'm very good at it, but I hope you like it. I thought it was gonna take way more time to finish writing it, and hopefully the other chapters are not as long as this, but it's finally ready. Now I just need to make the cutscenes and add the dialogues to the game, which I hope won't take me that long. And speaking of writing and the script, I changed Tommy's dialogues to be a little more formal. So he's gonna be kind of like a posh personality, kind of like a fancy way of talking, because just giving you a little bit of his backstory, he's basically he was born on a rich family, but he loves working. So basically he is the son of very rich people, and his whole family was always rich, but for some reason he just loves working, and that's why he just works at 7-Elevens, and there's also another reason, but I won't get into it because of spoilers. So maybe for chapter 3's devlog I will tell you a little bit more about that. Now going into the design part, the pixel art part, I redesigned some of the item drops that you get when you defeat enemies or break the flowers and stuff. Previously I just had one type of HP drop and dream drop. The star gave you 1 HP and the dream drop gave you 1 dream drop. And now I added another 2 HP drops and another 3 dream drops. The star drop, which is the HP drop, previously gave you 1 HP and the dream drop gave you 1 dream drop. So right now we have another 2 HP drops which give you more HP. There's one that gives you 3 HP and the other one gives you 5 HP. And for the dream drops I added another 3 different versions. So just like Zelda games, one gives you, well, the old one gives you 1 steel, and then there's one that gives you 5 dream drops, then a bigger one that gives you 20 dream drops, and the biggest one that gives you 50 dream drops. So yeah, there's new drops that you will find all over the place to help you in your journey. This you will probably not be able to see on the demo because these basically appear after you upgrade a ton of HP and after you level up like way more. So, or maybe you will find the second tier of dream drops in the demo. So make sure you play it and check it out, and maybe if you're lucky you will get them. But yeah, this will be more noticeable in the final game. And finally, like just like I've been working on the past couple of months, I've been working on a ton of new buildings and a ton of new assets for the Neo-Kyo area of the game. And yeah, I know I've been telling this for the past 2 devlogs, but believe me when I say this is taking so much work. It's a ton of buildings and there's still a ton more that I'm gonna do. And actually on the last devlog I told you that hopefully this month I will be able to finish them and start building the actual city, like placing the buildings and stuff. But to be honest, it's probably gonna take a month or 2 more to do that because yeah, it's a very very big city. So I've worked on trees, for example, I worked on new buildings, I worked on new tile sets, and overall environments for the, specifically for the Imperial Palace area, the Ginza area, and the Tsukiji Fish Market area. Right now I'm still working on and more items for the Tsukiji Fish Market. And that's it for the new stuff, and that's basically it for the whole devlog since there hasn't been any bugs that I found this month either. So yeah, there were no fixes, there were only new additions to the game. So yeah, that's all for this month's devlog. Make sure you like the video, subscribe to the channel, and leave a comment with any suggestions on what to improve or overall cool ideas that you'd like to see on the channel and on the game. Also, shout out to my supporters on Patreon at the supporter tier or higher. You guys are awesome and all of this wouldn't be possible without you. If you want to appear on the YouTube video or you want exclusive behind the scenes and early access to videos like this, please go to patreon.com/wellgolem to support me. Every little bit of help counts and it is greatly appreciated. Thank you so much for watching and I hope you enjoyed the video and I'll see you on the next one.